ఇంటర్మీడియట్ విద్యా రంగంలో అగ్రగామి మన ఎన్ఎస్ఆర్ ఇంపల్స్ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూషన్ ఐఐటి జేఈఈ అయినా నీట్ అయినా తిరుగులేని విద్యా సంస్థ ఎన్ఎస్ఆర్ ఇంపల్స్.
Yes, students, we are just discussing about fleshy fruits, right? So here, based on pericarp, we divide the fruit, fleshy fruits, into five categories. What are they? Now, the first one is called berry, and next one is pepo, and the third one is pome, fourth one is hesperidium, and the fifth one is drupe. And the fifth one is nothing but what? Drupe. So how many categories we have? Five categories. What we discuss now? Pepo we have discussed completely. Pepo we have discussed. What is the second one we have to discuss now? Pepo. I mean berry we have discussed. Now let us continue with pepo. Under fleshy fruits, let us talk about second one, pepo. Now let us see the characteristics of pepo. So try to remember in this. We are going ahead with the berry, pepo, pome, hesperidium, drupe. We are just going to continue in the same sequence, right? And all will come under the fleshy fruits. All will come under fleshy fruits, right? Now this pepo, if you take tricarp ellary, syncarpus. What's the meaning of tricarp ellary? Tri means three carpels. So we discussed earlier, when we discussed about gynoecium, we discussed about monocarp ellary, bicarp ellary, tricarp ellary, pentacarp ellary, multicarp ellary. We discussed along with the examples, right? So here tricarp ellary meaning, what is the meaning? Number of carpels are three. How many carpels? Number of carpels are three. So here number of carpels are three. Syncarpus. So what do we say here? Syncarpus. Syncarpus means carpels are fused. Apocarpus means carpels are free, and syncarpus means carpels are fused, right? Now apart from this, here we can say this shows inferior ovary. Inferior ovary. This is very very important to remember, and moreover it is unilocular. Moreover it is unilocular. So here inferior is ovary is very very important, because pepo is inferior ovary. Guys, if you remember, I think we studied about what you call perigynous, epigynous, you remember, right? There we studied superior ovary, inferior ovary, half inferior, half is superior ovary, you remember? Those characteristics are the basic fundamentals to be applied in most of the concepts. So perigynous, epigynous, hypogynous, did you remember? Three types of ovaries. So when you write inferior ovary, means the complete diagram of arrangement of floral parts on the thalamus, the diagram should appear in front of your closed eyes. In front of your eyes you have to see, and you have to remember all the examples. What are the examples of inferior ovary? That concept you need to recollect it once. Apart from that, wherever inferior ovary is there, what is that concept and what are the examples? For example, for berry we studied superior ovary examples, inferior ovary examples. For the last class, berry. Berry, if you take solanum, lycopersicum, you remember cidium, guava. So where superior ovary is present, wherever inferior ovary is present, for that additionally you need to add the examples. Very very important. Pepo means, remember, tricarp ellary. Syncarpus, carpels are fused. Inferior ovary and unilocular. Right. Now in this case also, epicarp and thalamus both are fused and forms rind. What are fused? For banana also same. For banana also same, but banana is a berry. In banana also epicarp and thalamus are fused and forms a peel. Peel is what? Exocarp. Similarly, here also epicarp and thalamus are fused and forms the rind. The structure itself is called rind. And then mesocarp and endocarp, including placenta, are fleshy and edible. So what are all edible here? Mesocarp, endocarp, placenta. On which ovules are attached? Mesocarp, endocarp and placenta. So these three are, they becomes fleshy and moreover they are edible. So epicarp, thalamus fused to form the rind, and mesocarp, endocarp, placenta becomes fleshy and edible. Now this pepo, it's nothing but, it's a characteristic feature of family. Characteristic of, sometimes you will get the question, which family means Rutaceae. Cucurbitaceae, Nana. This is pepo, no? So you can take, it's nothing but characteristic feature of Cucurbitaceae. Now, you know, some specific concepts are very, very specific for families. For example, marginal placentation we studied. Marginal placentation is a characteristic feature of Fabaceae. Right, did you remember? Similarly, types of corolla, descendingly imbricate corolla. Corolla, you studied, right? Anterior largest petal, two wing petals, two small keel petals. It's found only in Fabaceae. Like that, for every family, there is a some specific character, some specific concept. For that concept, the specific family is an example. So, Cucurbitaceae, generally they contain, the type of fruit is pepo. So, when you take here, now let us take the examples. Let us take Cucurbitaceae. Examples means the plants which belong to Cucurbitaceae, they are nothing but Cucurbita maxima. Cucurbita maxima, it's commonly called as pumpkin, and other one is Cucumis sativum. Cucumis sativum, it's commonly called as cucumber. Okay, so what are they? Cucurbita maxima, it's commonly called pumpkin, okay, and Cucumis sativum, it's commonly called as cucumber. So Cucurbita maxima is pumpkin, Cucumis sativum is cucumber, right? Now in this case, what do you find? Pepo. Now let us see the pepo. So here I'm just drawing. So here it will be like this. Okay, now this is epicarp and this is thalamus. Both are fused and forms rind. So this is called as rind. Okay, so where to where is rind? From here to here, this part is called rind, right? Why? Because epicarp and thalamus, both of them fused and forms rind, right? Now in the center, what do you find in center? Now in center you can see placenta. This is a placenta. This is a placenta. What do you call this? This is placenta. And moreover it is endocarp. What is this here? What are edible here? Placenta I have drawn. What else we have to draw? Mesocarp and endocarp. Now this part, what you find here, this is called mesocarp. In the mesocarp, you can see arrangement of seeds. So seeds will be like this. So seeds will be like this. So here. Now these seeds, what you find here, it's called endocarp. Right, the seeds what you find, it's called endocarp. And what is said? Mesocarp, endocarp, placenta, all are fleshy and edible. Now this becomes fleshy and it is edible. Fleshy and edible. Okay, so this is nothing but cucurbita. Let us take cucurbita or any of this cucumis sativum or whatever it is, cucumber. Let us take, this is nothing but cucumber. Right guys, again I repeat, the outermost one what you can find here, this outermost one what you can find here, this is called epicarp. Outermost what you find is epicarp, outermost layer. Epicarp fused with thalamus. This is nothing but thalamus. What you can see here, this is called thalamus. And epicarp thalamus fused to form rind. So from here to here, this is called rind. And what you can see in the center you find the axis, the white colored one. Actually, for your understanding, I'm drawing darker. So this is nothing but placenta. Now, in the placenta, pulp is there. That is mesocarp. Within the mesocarp, seeds are there. Seeds are nothing but endocarp. Now all are fused, fleshy, and they are edible. Characteristic feature of cucurbitaceae. Right, guys. Again, I repeat. Pepo, tricarpellary, meaning three carpels. Syncarpus means carpels are fused. Inferior ovary and unilocular, meaning only one chamber. Epicarp and thalamus fused to forms the rind. Try to remember. Mesocarp, endocarp, placenta, all three are joined, fused, and they are fleshy. Moreover, they are edible. Characteristic of family Cucurbitaceae. Examples are Cucurbita maxima, also commonly called pumpkin. Cucumis sativum, commonly called cucumber. Now in this, epicarp, thalamus are fused and form rind. This part is rind. Now inside, what you find is placenta. Mesocarp, in the mesocarp you find endocarp. Endocarp are nothing but seeds. All are fused, fleshy, and they are edible. Cucumber, right? Now generally if you look at this part, so here, so here in this case, if you can see this, what you can see in this is nothing but, this is epicarp. What you can see in this is nothing but epicarp. Can you see that yellow colored ones, yellow colored outer one, yellow colored upper outer one? Okay. So what I'm peeling it out, okay. So what I've peeled it out. So this is called, yeah. See here. Now this is called epicarp. What you can see, yellow colored ones, this is called epicarp. Now this epicarp fused with the thalamus, and can see the white colored ones. You can see the white colored ones from here to here. This is completely from here to here. So including this part is called rind. So you can see here, epicarp and thalamus fused to form rind. Rind is from where to where? This is epicarp and white one is thalamus. From here to here, this is called rind. Where is that rind? This is the rind. What I am cutting and opening for you, that is called rind. So you know, in keera dosa or in dosa, generally in cucumber, so what I cutted from this part, yellow colored one is epicarp and thalamus is the white colored one. Both together, yellow epicarp, thalamus together, it forms what? Rind. So this part is called rind. Okay. Now innerly if you look at, now what is present here? Innerly placenta is here. Now can you see the axis here? Now here this axis. So what is that axis you find? Placenta. White colored stripes what you can find here are nothing but placenta. Within the placenta, yellow color fluid what you can see, that is mesocarp. That is mesocarp. Within the mesocarp what you find? Seeds. Now seeds are nothing but what? Endocarp. The seeds are nothing but endocarp. All are fused, joined, they becomes fleshy, and this is edible part. Now what is the type of placentation you can see? The type of placentation is axile placentation, right? So guys, what are the things you have to notify? Yellow colored layer what you find in this case is epicarp. White one is thalamus. Both fused and form this structure is called rind. And here the white colored ones is placenta. Yellow one what you find fluid, what you find is mesocarp. Inside what you find are stones. So these three are edible, and the type of placentation is axile placentation. Cucumber is a example, right? Right guys, so here epicarp and thalamus are fused, it form the rind. What are edible means? Meso, endocarp and placenta are edible. So this is nothing but what we call pepo. Pepo, the best examples are cucurbita cucumis, mostly we can take cucumber. Guys, before that, I just want to give you berry. Guys, for berry, I just forgot to give the diagram. Let me give you a diagram for the berry. So, here, I'll just draw the diagram here. So, here. So here in this case, you can see the berry here, I mean, so here this is nothing but arrangement of seeds you can find. So these are nothing but seeds. So these are nothing but seeds, right? And this is epicarp and this is mesocarp and the seeds what you can see is nothing but endocarp. So here endocarp seeds are present. So what is the diagram I have drawn here? The diagram what I have drawn is nothing but lycopersicle. What is that lycopersicle? It's commonly called tomato. Okay guys, for berry you need to draw this diagram, because either you can draw banana, musa. In musa you cannot make it out, right? So better I can take tomato as an example for berry. For berry I'm giving you the diagram, forgot to give. So here epicarp, mesocarp, endocarp. Endocarps are nothing but seeds are present, that you can take as a diagram for berry. Now what is the third category? Now we have, this is first one. Second one what we have discussed is nothing but what we have discussed, pepo we have discussed. Now let us go with pom. Okay, first one berry example, pepo I have given just back diagram. Now let us go with what is called pom. Now let us see the characteristics of pom. We can take bi2 multicarpellary and other conditions if you look at syncarpus. Syncarpus is a common thing. By here, so this is by 2 multicarpellary, means number of carpels are 2 many, and it is syncarpus. Including inferior ovary. Now in this case of the pom, when you look at what we can see in the pom here is a true fruit is surrounded by fleshy fruit, or you can say false fruit. Better you can take fleshy fruit itself is called as false fruit. Very, very important. What is said? True fruit is surrounded by false fruit. Okay, true fruit is present, false fruit is also present. In which one? That is very, very important one called pom. Very, very important. Now, what are the examples for the pom? You can take examples for the pom. For example, you can take Pyrus malus. Guys, remember, this is a scientific name for apple. And Pyrus communis is an example for pear. Okay, Pyrus malus is an example for apple. Pyrus communis is an example for pear. Okay, so in both of them, very, very important statement is this. You have to look at true fruit is surrounded by false fruit. That means in apple, both are present. True fruit is also present, false fruit is also present. Right. Now, let us draw the diagram for the foam. I'm just drawing the diagram for the foam. I'll just going to draw the same, like for apple, the same shape will come. So, let us take the diagram. So, if you take in case of apple, right? So, this is nothing but the apple. Now, in case of apple, if you see exactly in the center, now here you can find like this. Have you observed any time? Actually, I thought of getting the apple on the way, but I searched. Actually, this is not the apple season. Maybe find here and there, but I did not find apple on my way. So, I thought of getting apple also, but you can, you have at home apple, just cut it, cut the apple, then see exactly in the center you find the seeds will be there like this, the white color seeds. I am just making it as dark. So, white color seeds will be there. Now, these are nothing but the seeds, what you find. So, these are nothing but seeds. Seeds are nothing but what? Ovules. And this part is called true fruit. And this part is called true fruit. I hope this is visible. I hope this is visible. This part is called true fruit. Better I will write this side. If it is not visible, again you people will get. This is called true fruit. Now, what exactly is there in the center? These are called seeds. Seeds meaning what? Ovules. Okay, so I'll just draw right this side better. Now, what you can see, this is called true fruit. This total center one, what you can see, that is the actual true fruit. That means that is ovary is there, ovary develops into center part, inside ovules develops into seeds. That is center one, white colored one with the seeds, what you find, that is actually the true fruit. And that fruit, it's surrounded by false fruit. What is the false fruit here? The edible part, what you find in this case is thalamus. So, the white colored part, what you find here, what is edible here, that is nothing but thalamus. Thalamus is edible. That means true fruit is surrounded by false fruit. True fruit is in the center, the true fruit exactly in the center, that is surrounded by false fruit. What is a false fruit here? The false fruit, it develops from any other floral part. It develops from any other floral part. It may develop from calyx, it may develop from pedicel, or it may develop from thalamus. In case of apple, so what is this? This is nothing but Pyrus malus. Pyrus malus is commonly called as apple. Pyrus malus is a scientific name for apple. Okay, so what is the type of fruit in apple? This is nothing but pom. Pom is nothing but type of fruit in case of apple. So, again I repeat, guys listen carefully. Now, when you look at in this case, here pom is nothing but bi to multicarpellary. Number of carpels may be two or many. Syncarpus meaning carpels are fused and inferior ovary. So, in this case true fruit is surrounded by false fruit. This is a center one is called true fruit, that is ovary. Inside the ovary what you find? Seeds. Seeds means ovules. True fruit is exactly in the center, that is surrounded by false fruit. False fruit means what is edible here? Thalamus is edible. Very, very important. In apple, which part is edible? Fleshy thalamus. That's why we wrote in the false fruit, the example is apple. So, thalamus is edible. Apple, pear and all the strawberry also. Right? That also in that thalamus is edible. Right? And what are the examples? Pyrus malus, commonly called apple. Pyrus communis, pear. In both, in this case, both genus name is same, species name is different. Malus means apple will come, communis means pear will come. Right? Let's continue further. The next one is Hesperidium. What is the next one we have? Hesperidium. Now Hesperidium also, if you look at the characteristics, bitu multicarpellary, syncarpus, inferior ovary and with axile placentation, all characters we know. Number of carpels may be 2 to many, syncarpus, inferior ovary, and it is found with axial placentation. Even what you find, not the what you call POM, PEPO also you find axial placentation, right? Right. Now, apart from this, in this epi, this one very importantly, if you look at in Hesperidium, epicarpes thick and it is leathery. This is leathery with oil glands, right? And mesocarp, if you look at mesocarp is fibrous. Coming to endocarp, juicy and succulent. Juicy as well as succulent. So these are very, very important. Now if you take epicarp, mesocarp and endocarp. So what is the condition of epicarp? Very thick, moreover it is leathery, and very importantly what you find? Oil glands. So sometimes I'll get the question, in which you find epicarp is leathery with oil glands, means you have to take Hesperidium. And mesocarp is totally fibrous. So try to remember, this all are very, very important. Very fibrous. If you take fibers, will come out. Then endocarp, if you look at, it is juicy and succulent. Such type of characteristics you find in case of Hesperidium. Now let us take the examples for this. Citrus medica, it's commonly called as lemon, and citrus sinensis. Now look at the diagram, what we will draw generally, if you look at. So this is nothing but the lemon or whatever we just take, the cutted part. Just if you cut it, I'm just trying to give you an overview here. Okay, so this is lemon or whatever you take, sweet orange or whatever you take. Alright, so what you find outermost one? Outermost one in this case is nothing but epicarp. I think it's visible. So this is epicarp. And in the between what you find is mesocarp, and what you can see here is axial placentation. This is placenta. What you can see here is, this is placenta, right? In the center what you find, this is nothing but placenta. Now here you can see a juicy succulents like this. So this is juicy and succulents, and here what are present? Seeds are present. Okay, endocarp is juicy, succulent, and along with that seeds are present. Now here this is what we call hairy and juicy succulent. What is that? Endocarp. So what I am drawing here, this is nothing but citrus, lemon, or you can draw orange, right? So what you can see is epicarp is leathery, mesocarp is fibrous. Now if you see the innermost part, innermost part, this white color ridges, what you find is placenta. Placenta contain arrangement of seeds. Seeds are nothing but ovules. And what is the endocarp? Hairy, juicy, succulent endocarp. And this endocarp is edible part. And you can take example. What are the examples? Citrus medica, that's lemon. Citrus sinensis, nothing but what? Orange. Now if you can see that lemon thing, if you can see the lemon part, so here, right. Now if you see the lemon part in this case, I'll just show you this one. Now in this case, when you see, now this is outer one, upper one, what you can see here. In this case, what I'll cut it, that is epicarp. So generally, I thought of getting orange, but I didn't get. Anyway, so here what you can see, this is nothing but epicarp. What you can see here, this is nothing but epicarp. So in this epicarp, what did I say? Leathery with oil glands. And when you take the orange, when you are just opening the peel, so this, if you crush it like this, oil glands will come. If you crush it like this, some oil glands will come. This is leathery. If you can touch it, that is leathery. Then what you find inner side here, now mesocarp. Mesocarp, endocarp, if you look at mesocarp, if you see the here, mesocarp, this is fibrous. Sweet orange, when you are opening the peel, the fibers will come. So you will open the fibers like that. That mesocarp is fibrous. Epicarp is leathery. This is leathery. Volatile oil glands are there. Mesocarp is fibrous. Right. Now what is endocarp? You can see the endocarp, what you can see here, this is juicy. Can you see juicy heads? Yeah, you can see so many heads. Yes or no? There are so many hairs. They are hairy, juicy, succulents. And here what you find, this is endocarp. Endocarp is edible. And can you see white color ridges? This is placenta, and this shows what is called axial placentation. Right. Now this is nothing but endocarp. Endocarp, juicy, succulent, hairy, and it is edible. So this is nothing but citrus medica, nothing but what? Lemon. Right. Thank you. So when it comes to matter of this, so this is Hesperidium. Now when it comes to the matter of this, let us revise it once again. Hesperidium is nothing but bi to multicarpellary. So you find syncarpus, inferior ovary is there with the axial placentation. Have to remember, epicarp is thick and leathery with oil glands. When you take out the peel of orange, you will get oil glands, right? Volatile oil glands. Mesocarp is fibrous. You will remove the fibers. When sweet orange or orange, when you say, fibers will come out. Endocarp is hairy, and so here you have to write hairy, juicy, succulent, that is edible. Citrus medica is lemon. Citrus sinensis is orange. And this you take, this is epicarp. Mesocarp is fibrous. You can see some fibers will be there. And endocarp, if you look at here, this is placenta. These are the ovules, nothing but seeds. And endocarp will have hairy, juicy, succulents. It's edible part generally. And this is a diagram, citrus, lemon. That is an example for what? Hesperidium. I hope Hesperidium part is clear. Let us continue further. Now let us talk about the droop one. The next one is droop. So let us go, fifth one is droop. Now in this droop also we can say bi to multicarpellary, right? And then syncarpus, right? And very importantly, when you take bi to multicarpellary, syncarpus, gynecium, now in this case, if you look at, epicarp is thin, mesocarp is juicy and succulent, edible. In case of, so I'll write here itself example. So we can take mango. What is the scientific name for mango? Mangifera indica. What is the example? Mangifera indica. Coming to, or there is one more example. You can take one more example where mesocarpis fibrous. So for this you can take example Coccus nucifera. What is Coccus nucifera? That is nothing but coconut. We are simply discussing three, mesocarp, then endocarpis, hard and stony endocarp. So we are trying to distinguish epicarp, mesocarp and endocarp. So droop is very, very simple for all of us to understand. Simply number of carpels may be by two multicarpellary. Sometimes mostly it all contains what is called superior ovary. Sometimes it contains superior ovary. In some of the fruits we find superior ovary. Syncarpus meaning carpels are fused. By two multicarpellary means two to many carpels. Now what happens? Coming to three layers of pericarp. Epicarp is thin, very thin layer. Mesocarp is juicy, succulent, edible, where in case of mangifera, and mesocarp is fibrous and it is said to be edible. In which one you find Coccus nucifera, coconut, and endocarp is hard and stony. So for this let us take the mango as an example. If you take mango, so if I draw the mango, let us take this is a mango. So if you take this is a mango, in this what we say epicarp is very, very thin. So you can take the thin layer. Centermost what you can see is nothing but the seed. You can see this is nothing but the seed. This is very hard and it is not edible. What you can see, center one is mesocarp. So this mesocarp is juicy and moreover succulent. So this is edible. What we eat is nothing but mesocarp. Mesocarp we eat in case of mango, juicy and succulent. And what you find endocarp what you can see, hard and stony endocarp. Most of the time you will get the question that where you will find hard and stony endocarp. Most of the times you will get the question that where you find hard and stony endocarp. In mango what is very hard and stony? Yes, the centermost seed. What is very hard and stony? Centermost seed is nothing but hard and stony endocarp. Now this is what example in case of, let us take this is example, that is mango. Right, in both cases what is edible? Mesocarp is edible. Right, for example if you take coconut, if you take this is coconut. So for example if you take the broken coconut made into half, right, for God we use it, no, right. So if you take in this, let us take this is coconut, the brown colored one, and center you find white color one, coca, right, and this is mesocarp, and in this case the mesocarp is fibrous. The coca what we eat, right, the coca what we eat is fibrous and that is edible. Now this is nothing but what? This is nothing but Coccus nucifera. So this is nothing but Coccus nucifera. Right, in this case outermost region what you find? This is pericarp. Pericarp what you find in Coccus nucifera? Pericarp is not edible. Pericarp, the hard brown color one is not edible. Pericarp is not edible. Just below the pericarp what you find? Mesocarp. Fibrous, that is called coca, we call that is edible, where in case of Coccus nucifera, right. These two are examples for droop. I repeat, droop is bi or multicarpellary, syncarpus, epicarp is thin, mesocarp is juicy in case of mango and it is edible. Mesocarp may be fibrous and edible in case of Coccus nucifera. Difference is what? Here juicy, here it is fibrous. That's why we are talking two examples. Endocarp is hard and stony. So here in mango epicarp thin, mesocarp is juicy edible, hard stone endocarp. pericarp is not edible in case of Coccus nucifera. What is edible in Coccus nucifera is nothing but mesocarp, that is fibrous. So we completed fleshy fruits, all five types. What are they? Berry, pome, pepo, hesperidium, and last one is drupe.